All right, the plan is that we're going to turn the tables. Usually I'm the one who looks like a cock here, but you're about to witness, hopefully, Brendan and Noah eat a little bit of humble pie, because we've got 6 wines this week. Each of these wines is an Italian grape varietal made in Australia. You may not know this, but we actually work for a winery that makes Italian grape varietals in Australia. Strap in, get yourself a glass of wine, and let's taste some Italian wines.
Cool. Awesome. All right. Well, this is only moderately intimidating because, you know, we have a winery and we make Italian varieties in Australia. So if I cock this up, then egg on my face.
Medium weight white wine. Nice little yellow licks here. I'm going to guess Fiano.
Definitely got the acidity of a Fiano. It does have the fruit flavor as well. It is this like really nice sort of, it does kind of taste like you're eating a freshly picked grape, which would make sense. The green highlights in Fiano always wig me out. Like looking down on this, it is like lime cordial. It's only when you come down to the side that you can sort of see that yellow color. It's absolutely bizarre.
Bit interesting on the palate. Look, there's fruit sweetness here. There definitely has that like quite typical waxy texture, but it's just appearing this, giving me like a bit of a sweet angle, which I find really just peculiar. I haven't seen that in a while.
Yeah, I quite like it. Good acid, like lazy, steely, well-driven. I'm gonna grab 3 bottles. I like it, $30. It is that kind of like perfect little afternoon easy drinker, very appealing. I love that kind of, there's a bit of lazy interest here, which I really quite like. There's this nice kind of savory backbone to it, which I love about Australian Italian varieties. To be honest, this is like, there's a nice kind of pineapple chew to it as well.
Fiano, I'll have 3 bottles of that and I'll pay, I should know the market rate for an Australian made Fiano. I'll pay $33 a bottle for that.
Moving on to wine number 2, we're going something that's kind of got like the slightest amount of haze to it, which I kind of admire as well. You know, any winemaker that's willing to leave a bit of haze or something in, you know, in a wine means they're not trying to impact it too much.
Acid's really kind of flat. Texturally, it's quite broad. Again, that really lovely kind of chewy Maya lemon, nashi pear, like white nectarine thing going as well.
Quite saline on the front of the palate. Feels like it'd go really nicely with, if it was really cold and paired with some seafood or something along those lines, I reckon it'd be right up my alley, but just drinking it at this temperature in this space with no oyster in this hand.
Interesting, really well made, really well crafted, and I do wonder whether or not that batonnage technique was A, either wise or B, intentional, because this has very low acidity, like almost no acidity, and it's kind of like, it's thick, already has enough texture.
But again, it's really pleasant. It's like got this crisp kind of orchard fruit, like apple pear thing to it that's really quite pleasant. Texturally, it's great, but I just wish there was a little bit more acid to kind of give it a little bit more energy.
I know I said salt at first, but there is a saline finish on it, but it does have this sort of warmth of honey going on. I'm gonna stick with Fiano because, again, a one-trick pony. That'll be a bit more. That'll be 38.
$25 is probably what I'd like to pay for this, but I'd grab 6. I reckon this is pretty crowd-pleasing. I'd take this over to mum and dad's. I'd have this with a roast chook. Like, it's got that kind of energy. It's quite good, but yeah, just a wish I had a little bit more.
I think we're beyond the point where, you know, our understanding of rosé means that, you know, we need to comment on the colour, because colour for rosé for a lot of people has become this. So they've nailed the colour if you're going for that Provence style.
I would buy a dozen of that. That is exactly the sort of rosé that I like drinking. We get them on the show all the time and they fit into one of two categories, yes or no. This is yes for me.
Fun, great, delicious, brilliant, like, if that is like grown and made in a sustainable way with low water use, I'm all for it. And I'd happily pay $28 a bottle and I would buy 12. Like, great, like cannon fodder wine. If you're gonna buy rosé, you can get these at really good price points. Typically, they won't be above $30 in Australia, but yeah, great deal, love it.
Acid, check, big wins. Fruit profile, excellent. Texture, awesome. This is pretty much great a rosé as you can kind of get. It's refreshing, it's simple, it's delicious. It does exactly what it needs to. You're not really asking for much here. I love the acid here. It's just like so puckering. It's got this like grapefruity saltiness to it that's really awesome as well.
It smells like 2015, you know? Like no one even knew what Corona was. Well, they did, but Vin Diesel drank it. Like it was just a completely different time. We'll have, I mean, I don't really want to spend a lot of money on rosé, truth be told, so I'll go 28 on it, be optimistic about it, but yeah, lovely, strawberries, clean palate, no tannin, obviously, but yeah, big fan. And I'm poor. Red Boy. We've got three Red Boys now. And I had a salami sandwich for lunch, so just had to burp when I was saying that. But it's going to pair really nicely with these reds, hopefully. A little bit of Italian meat.
Oh, damn, that's awesome. It smells fantastic, yeah? A lot of dry cinnamon.
Great Valpolicella or entry-level Nebbiolo or playful Nero d'Avola. Sangiovese as well. This looks great. That is excellent. I really love this. Juicy, spicy, savory. Tannin is just lithe and seamless and elegant and pretty.
I reckon it's narrow. It's a light Italian red. I work for a winery that makes light Italian red.
Fantastic. Tarn roses affected Nebbiolo, the full-blown tannin, like from, what was a reference in the last video? It was from Bang to Bang. It's just completely full and svelte. Beautiful example of contemporary Nebbiolo, I believe.
And then underneath it's like this lovely kind of rambly, great mix of like blue and blue oak and like blue fruited, like Slovenian oak, and there's this lovely kind of red cherry. This is excellent. For some reason, I'm gonna call this Barbera, which is generally a grape variety I'm not a massive fan of.
That'll be $42 and I'll have six of those, only because I can get similar sort of wine. Actually, I shouldn't bring this factor in. I'll have a dozen of them. Forget I spoke, it's a dozen.
Yeah, I can get stuff, discount on shit at work.
That doesn't factor into you watching this video at home. I apologize to you sincerely for going down that path. All right.
Wine number five, going deeper, darker, denser, going deep. Oh, smells awesome. It smells like plums, man. It smells like blood plums. Thickness, it's great. Going deep.
Bit of meat to it, bit of herb, bit of like depth to it. This could be a Sange. This could be a deeper Sange.
Closed all the doors, forgotten about it, come back, open it up, and then it's just like, hi, I'm stale. Nose on this is
the thickness, down with the thickness. I mean, where am I going with this, Lockie? I don't really know where I'm going with this. It smells really good is what I'm saying. In fact, it actually smells like it's got a really great toasty oak element to this as well. Like there's been a little bit more, I don't know, playfulness to the winemaking here. They've kind of taken a few more nods from other territories rather than just Italy.
Chewy, spicy, rich, broad, great little expression there right here. Like really good fun. I just think that tannin profile is a winner here.
Probably needs to get over it a little bit. Oh, no. No. Oh. Didn't like it at first, and then it's got this nice little sprinkle of strawberry on the end, which I do really like. I think it's a narrow again.
Yeah, wow. Montepulciano, I think. Real classy. I'm not a big fan of Monty in Australia. Now, this way could well be Sangiovese, but either way, what I'm trying to say is that these varieties that seemingly reference Italy tend not to do very well, but when they reference completely other sort of aspects and they just try to make really good quality wine from a place, which this is.
And wine number six. Surely one of these has to be Nebbiolo. Has to be.
That ain't Neb. That's cool. What a cool expression. I see this a lot of Australian Neb, this Amaro bitter herb.
Yep, that is Nebbiolo. And that is absolutely excellent too. That tannin is just mouth coating and rich and pure, like black tea kind of thing. It's got this lovely bergamot character.
Okay, I'm not gonna tell you what I think it is right now. I'm gonna bring it up later and we're gonna find out together if this is an Italian grape varietal, okay?
What would be termed the Amaro bittering herbs, or mountainous herbs, fennel seed, brilliant.
Yeah, that's really fun. It's like, it's not the same flavor, but it's the same sensation as like a cinnamon chewing gum or something like that. It's got this real like crackly thing going on, which I'm really into.
There's only one wine here I didn't buy 12 of. I am incredibly biased when it comes to these wines.
Hard to pick one in a lineup. It's either number four or six for me, but like this is pretty amazing. This is pretty, pretty excellent. So I'm gonna have to probably give it to this, but you just don't get Nebbiolo and Australia much better than that. But let's see what the boys think.
$38 again, back to my favorite number and a dozen. But yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that was a mess. I hope the other guys do better than me.
So I think maybe we should trust what the other boys think and see how we compare.
Ah, you guys should have nailed this.
I really hope so, but I said that last couple of tastings and I really didn't.
No. But they were like, yeah, I've sort of got an idea about these wines. You work as an Australian winemaker making Italian wines.
I know.
So this is right up your...
I'm right up my alley and it's total gauntlet. Yep, 100%.
How do you feel about it, Noah? You feel confident?
No. Well, it's like, here's the thing. Like, You are trained as like as wine professionals to identify typicity of like both like variety and region. So you go Adelaide, who was you expecting Pinot Noir, Shiraz, Chardonnay, sparkling.
Yes.
You're expecting, you know, like if you go to France, you're expecting, if you go to Champagne, you're expecting a Champagne style from a certain amount of different varieties and things like this. But we're breaking the rules here, which is great about the wine industry. So it's like these are Italian varieties planted in Australia, which is, you know, to an average consumer outside of Australia, they'd have no idea that this actually exists.
True. Yeah.
So like, there's no real blueprint to kind of follow, which is exciting both on as a wine producer to go, like, we can really break the rules and do whatever we want and create our own category. But as tasting, it's like, I don't know what the fuck any of these could possibly be.
Yeah, there's no signposts.
There's no, like, when you see this, like, it must be this.
Let's start me being wrong with wine number one, which I called a Fiano.
I also called it as Fiano.
Yeah, it's got those, like, green highlights in it, which is pretty typical of it.
It's got that great, like, leasiness, the acid's good, texture's nice and kind of round. It really, like, screams Fiano, but it also could be
Vermentino
or a Garganica or a fucking, I don't know, like something.
But look, I was on Fiano as well. I really loved the wine. I thought the wine was all class. I wanted 12 and I wanted to pay $30 for it. I thought the smell, like there's like that sort of, you know, wonderful like white nectarine, basil, pesto, there's a few
like oaky thing going on there as well, which is kind of, is a bit of a red herring with Fiano.
Touch acidic for me. I found it just to be a bit like sort of almost, I don't know, it's just because I had a salami sandwich for lunch, but a bit refluxy almost. But I got three bottles of it for $33 and I did call it Fiano.
I got three for 30. I really liked the wine, but I'd have no need for more Fiano. So three bottles is fine.
How much does it cost, Locke?
Great. That's exactly the kind of area.
Like right in the smack bang in the middle.
I called Riccatera for producer as well.
Ricca?
Yeah. Oh, from three at the buzzer.
There you go, mate. Absolutely clutched up with the Riccatera call.
Yeah.
Great shout.
Really good example of Australian Fiano. Big fans.
One of the largest growers of Fiano in Australia too.
Comfortably.
Maybe the largest, I don't know. Probably, like him or Corio. But yeah, really good.
Very cool. And Riverland, awesome.
Fly the flag.
Fly the flag for Riverland.
Number two, not just because, not entirely because I only know one white Italian grape variety off the top of my head, but I call this Fiano as well.
Look, I'll be honest, as cruel as it sounds, if that's Fiano, it's probably one of the worst Fianos I've ever tried. I'm so sorry if it is Fiano.
Really,
I reckon I've had this before. I know what it is. Well, obviously I don't know what it is because I can't say it, but I can't get the words out of the mouth. Like I've absolutely had this before. This no acid, really globular, sort of like green papaya thing. Is it Bianca Delasano? Is it?
It really is quite flabby.
Yeah.
Like there isn't enough acid there.
It reminds
me of Garganica, but this doesn't have the acid of like a Sauvage kind of thing. So I'm still going with Garganica.
I think this could be that Friuli variety.
Ribolla?
No, the other one. the other Friuli variety. That Quelea are known for making.
Spenska.
Well,
they don't know.
Well done.
They don't know. Yeah.
I really didn't like this. I'm really sorry. I'm just got to have some acid in some white wines.
I bought six of them, and I was going to pay $38 a bottle.
I actually kind of liked the texture, even though there is a bit of lack of acid. Sometimes I like no acid.
Yeah,
so I grabbed half a dozen just in case I need something with
the
acid.
The vatnage on it was fine. There's some really
texturally, it's great.
Yeah.
I wanted to pay $25.
How much did it cost?
Insolia.
I haven't tried this before, and I'm really sorry, guys. You know how much we love you.
Yeah, the Chalmers family are the reason that we are still a business.
We wouldn't exist if it wasn't the Chalmers family.
It's genuinely true.
Just not my bag.
Oh, look, and this is the thing with the Chalmers family as well. It's like they're doing this thing where they're bringing in all these varieties from Italy and just like, let's figure out how it works. They also have to figure out how to make it.
So yeah, they're the first. Like this is probably like one of the first Inzolias ever made in Australia.
Yeah.
Or definitely probably from the first planted vines. That's wild.
Like, so like they're learning as they go. So I think they'd probably be like, yeah, I wish I had more acid. But behind that, it's like pretty awesome.
Yeah, no, it is. Inzoli vines imported by Chalmers in 2015. First Inzoli produced by Chalmers in 2018. So these are more than light. And this is their bush vine. I imagine this is their the first Inzoli vine. So they're venturing into the great unknown.
Yeah, well.
Exactly.
At the forefront.
Yeah, 100%.
Not at the forefront. This is classic.
Yay!
Like strawberries and cream.
Yeah, fantastic.
Impossible. The only thing I could possibly hate about this wine is it's too expensive.
Yeah, there's a good chance it will be. It's tasty as hell, though.
I was thinking Neb, Sange.
I went Sanya
as well. I thought this was...
You guys are idiots. It's a rosé. Come on, be serious. Rosé, guys, fucking hell.
Yeah, from the rosé region of Italy.
Clone of Nebbiolo, perhaps. But I wanted $12.28. I thought it was a pretty fair price for it.
12 for 25.
12 for 28.
Oh, clean sweep. Let's go. Sweep. Great rosé. What do you got,
73.
Lucky?
How much?
Hey! Awesome bargain!
Awesome. Absolute
great wine. Great wine.
Look at that. Got Rossa Valley Rosé. Yep, that's the variety.
Rosé is the variety.
It's the variety. I don't think they tell you the variety.
Told you.
It's Torsi Matthews, so he does muck around with some cool stuff. It literally doesn't. Oh, Sangiovese.
Hey!
Sangiovese. Nice, love that.
So not Rosé.
Excellent Rosé.
Nailing the colour.
Yeah, like, that's really, exactly the first thing I said, was like, textbook. Look at that colour.
So
how do you not want to drink that? Serve it in pints with a wedge of lemon.
Yummy.
It's a lemon lime and bitters. Welcome to me guessing Nero for the rest of the tasting. Wine number four. I kid, I didn't call Nero for the rest of the
tasting. I will be real, I didn't guess Nero for any of these.
Really?
And that could concern me because it's very high likelihood that one of these are indeed Nero. I guess two as Nebbiolo though. Yeah. So it's one of them.
Really? Yeah. Oh, I did not think this had the talent to be a Neb.
No, neither did it until the last one. Then I knew that was more than likely almost 100% positively Neb. But either way, I actually enjoyed the wine. I thought it was really fantastic.
Loved.
Yes.
Yeah. This might be my wine lineup. It's I was umming and ahhing between this and another one, but this is class. This is amazing. So good.
Yeah.
Such a good wine. It's so savory. It's juicy. It's got great texture. Like. Love this wine. Yeah.
I paid a lot of money for these next three wines. I paid $55 and 12. I thought it was worthy.
I was going to drop 42 for a does.
I was at $40 for 12. I thought it was might have been just been really good Barbera.
Ooh.
That's fine.
But yeah, really good.
How much does it look?
Whoa. There we go.
Negro Amaro.
Close. Wow. Close. But no cigar.
Negro Amaro.
And we were in the north, but you were south, so you mean geographically as far as the context of its home area.
Yeah, that's obviously what I was picking up on there.
Yeah. So Negro Amaro, a wonderful, I believe, Calabrian great variety.
Yep.
Correct me if I'm wrong. We've made Negro Amaro here.
Once, yes.
And then never again.
it was blended away.
It was, it went to the BVS.
If you made it like that, you should keep making it.
Big vat
in
the sky. That's
awesome, isn't it?
That's a really good example. I remember encountering this once before, saying the exact same thing. I reckon we may have even tried this on the show in the early days.
Back in the day.
Yeah, and we had a very similar result. We were very impressed.
Yeah, I remember I went to the Correal Solidor a few years ago for like a friend's birthday, and this was the bottle I went home with because I just like, it was like $30. I just thought it was delicious. It's great. Correal winemaking at its finest. Awesome stuff.
So, Nero number two.
I thought this was Nero. I thought this was Nero. Like, I thought this was, it had that like bright, sprightly acid juiciness.
The nose is
like,
awesome.
You know, It, like, the acid's just a little bit peaky, but it's a pretty excellent little wine.
I love the oak on this. Mm-hmm. There was a decent amount of oak, and I thought it was like just classily, like really, really well done, really well put together.
Absolute sour cherry.
I went Sange with it though.
You know what's
but Nero could well be.
You know what's crazy? I hated this wine when I first tasted it because it was so reductive on the nose, and now it smells absolutely amazing.
I did pick up a little bit of reduction when I first tasted it, but it's definitely lost. This could be Sam's. This could be like a Svenjoski number.
I wanted to pay $60 and buy 12. I loved it.
I was at 3 and 35.
I was at 1. I'm now at 12 and I'll pay 48.
What a turn.
Dude, huge turn. It smelled like shit when we first opened it. I was so angry. Yeah, it's delicious now though. How much is it?
Hey! Nice. Well done. Slot for Nero, to be honest.
How many?
3. It was a reductive vintage.
I was so rude about this wine.
Wow, there you go.
Oh, that's again, awesome. I don't need more narrow.
That is amazing.
Dude, that's drinking so well now.
Well done. That's so good.
Don't watch this video, man. I was so rude about this wine in the open.
It wouldn't be us trying our own wines if we didn't shit on it.
No, but I've come around on it. I changed it.
Dude, that was all off your own bat, man. That was all off your own bat. That's a good looking wine.
How's the tannin on that, though?
Dude, we didn't even put that much oak in it. That was like barely any.
It's been a bit of time in Slovenian oak.
Slovenian, the big stuff.
That's gone really well.
But that's just Adelaide Hills Narrow. It has this like lovely blueberry character to
it. I'm still trying to understand how he made wine that good.
Oh, shut up.
All right. Caroline did. Caroline, yeah, it wasn't you.
All right, to finish us off.
Okay.
Wine lineup.
Neb.
Wine lineup.
Neb.
Amazing stuff. Nebbiolo. 100% Nebbiolo. If not Nebbiolo, Sangiovese. Pick. But epic.
Epic.
Like Luke Lambert level, like top tier. This is, you cannot get Australian Nebbiolo better than this. You just cannot.
Like, great. Stunning.
Yeah, I bought a dozen.
I bought a dozen. Clean sweep. Let's go.
I wanted to find out if Gamay was Italian. Is it Italian?
It is not Italian. It is French. It is from the Beaujolais region of central France.
Probably not Gamay then, is it? It's given that you two Nebheads have just been like, it's definitely Nebbiolo. Yeah.
Hey, dude, we could be so
I'm Nebbiolo heads by proxy.
It's happened before. Well, I mean, you just tasted your own wine. You didn't recognize it. So again,
I call it Sangiovese, bro.
Yeah,
we called it Nero.
Yay!
All right, so I wanted a dozen of it for $38.
I wanted a dozen for 75.
Dozen for 65.
Nice. Dude, you're on fire this week.
He's on it. He's on it. I checked
out.
That's a cracker. I checked out these guys. I was in Beechworth like 2 weeks ago. Went round, picked up a bottle of this. And it tasted like this, funnily enough.
Fancy that!
Pretty good!
Well done! I liked it then, I like it now. I liked it with context, without context. Yeah, excellent stuff.
So, one of the lineup. That, go.
Yeah, that was pretty bit of a no-brainer.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, guys. We'll catch you next time.
Cheers.
See ya.
Ciao. Bye.